Hello all and welcome to Success EduTech. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, share and kindly subscribe the channel. Please press the bell icon to get more notifications on videos. Myself is Manjari Kashyap. I have a master's in science and with a teaching experience of more than 5 years. I will teach you class 8 science CBSE board through NCERT books. The second chapter we are covering the microorganisms friend and foe. I have already covered different topics of this chapter in my previous 10 videos. The link of my previous videos are given in the description box. Kindly go through it. The topics which I have covered are microorganisms and classification, where do microorganisms live, making of curd and bread, use of microorganisms in bakery, commercial use of microorganisms, fermentation, medicinal use of microorganisms, antibiotics, vaccine, increasing soil fertility and cleaning of the environment. In today's video, I am covering the topic of harmful microorganisms, in which we will see diseases of plants, animals and humans. Okay, so let's go through the chapter to discuss today's topic. In the last videos, we have covered that how microorganisms are beneficial or as a friend to us. Now, microorganisms are foe or enemy to us. How they are enemy and how they are harmful to us, let's study. Microorganisms are harmful in many ways. Some of the microorganisms cause disease in human beings, plants and animals. Because they cause disease in human beings and in plants and animals, they are called harmful microorganisms or they are called as a foe. Such disease-causing microorganisms are called pathogens. The microorganisms which cause disease are given the word pathogens. Path is the word related to disease and gen is for generating. So those microorganisms or those organisms who generate disease are called the pathogens. Some microorganisms spoil food, clothing and leather. Apart from causing disease, they also spoil the food items, the cloth and the leather items. In this way, they are harmful for us. Let us study more about their harmful activities. Disease causing microorganisms in humans. How these microorganisms enter in our body and cause disease? These microorganisms which cause disease, known as pathogens, enter our body through the air we breathe, the water we drink, or the food we eat. These are the three means by which they enter into our body. Through our breathing system, through our food and water we drink, and through direct contact. So they can also get transmitted by direct contact with an infected person or carried by an animal. So microbial diseases that can spread from an infected person to a healthy person through air, water, food or physical contact is called communicable disease, because they are communication means from one to another. So these microorganisms, they communicate from one person to another, and the means of communication are air, water, food or physical contact. So these diseases which occur due to these four means, by these four means, air, water, food or physical contact, these diseases are called or categorized as communicable diseases. Examples of these communicable diseases are cholera, common cold, chicken pox and tuberculosis. Now you can understand that why physical distance is being maintained to avoid the spread of corona, because it is also a communicable disease. Now how this virus or how the disease spreads by air? There's an example. When a person suffering from common cold sneezes, fine droplets of moisture carrying thousands of viruses are spread in the air. As we all know that microorganisms are very, very small, so there are more than thousands of viruses in a single droplet of sneeze. So when a person coughs or sneezes, his fine droplets of sneezing. It carries a lot of viruses, thousands of viruses, and thus these viruses from the infected person spreads in the air by his cough droplets or by his sneezing. These viruses now they can, which are present now in the air, they can enter into the healthy person through the breathing process, and they can cause infection, and the new life cycle of the viruses starts in the healthy person. So when a person coughs or sneezes, what he should do? The Bujo is asking, then how do you prevent the spread of communicable diseases, the disease which is transferred by air? How do you prevent the spread of this communicable disease? And the smart Paheli is giving the answer. We should keep a hanky or on the nose and mouth while sneezing. It is better to keep a distance from infected persons. So nowadays we are wearing masks for our protection and for the protection of others from this communicable disease. And one should also stay away from a person if he is or she is having the common cold or cold. The next topic which I will cover in next video is carrier or vector of diseases. I will cover the given slide in my next video. Continue watching. It will be posted very, very soon. Thank you for watching.